In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Good morning and welcome to this service on the second Sunday of Christmas. First Sunday of the actual New Year. So I'd like to start by wishing you a Happy New Year. Good to be with you, and I hope you've had a good Christmas time as we still celebrate Christmas until Epiphany. The tree's still up, the decorations are still up at home, and it's good to be with you today. So let us start with a carol. Hear the words of the angel to Joseph. You should call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Therefore, let us seek the forgiveness of God through Jesus, the Saviour of the world. God our Father, you sent your Son full of grace and truth. Forgive our failure to receive him. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, our Saviour, you were born in poverty and laid in a manger. Forgive our greed and rejection of your ways. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Spirit of love, your servant Mary responded joyfully to your call. Forgive the hardness of our hearts. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now we sing the Gloria.
Thank you.
So let us pray. Almighty God, in the birth of your Son, you have poured on us the new light of your incarnate word and shown us the fullness of your love. Help us to walk in his light and dwell in his love, that we may know the fullness of his joy, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, just as he chose us in Christ. Before the foundation of the world, to be holy and blameless before him in love. God destined us for adoption as his children through Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of God's will, to the praise of his glorious grace that he freely bestowed on us in the Beloved, in him whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace, that he lavished on us with all wisdom and insight. He has made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure that he set forth in Christ, as a plan for the fullness of time, to gather up all things in Christ, things in heaven and things on earth. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of God, who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance towards redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. This is the word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. The word became flesh and lived among us. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving, make music to our God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to John. The true light which enlightens everyone was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory. The glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, he who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he was before me." From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known. This is the gospel of the Lord. May I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The true light which enlightens everyone was in the world, and the world came into being through him. We have, just 8 days ago, welcomed the light of the world into our lives. One of the things that saddens me is all those pictures over on Facebook of people having put the tree away, having packed away Christmas. Christmas we should be celebrating until at least we celebrate the arrival of the wise men on the 6th of January Epiphany, which actually we will be keeping next Sunday. But of course, it's so sad that people are packed away. you know, and forgetting it, as if Christmas Day marks the end of Christmas celebrations, whereas actually it's the beginning of them. And how do we keep those things going in our lives? How do we keep celebrating? We go into New Year. And obviously New Year's Eve celebrations were a little bit more subdued this year, better than last year, but more subdued than the year before, and hopefully more subdued than they will be next year. Christmas is an opportunity, if nothing else, to talk about Jesus. To drop it into the conversations, for people to hear those familiar stories. People often talk about lights and candles. In my last house, I used to put some Christmas lights up, but I had a big cross that was a big three-story house, big cross at the top of the house, outside, and that would stay up until Candlemas. All the other lights would come down at Epiphany, but that light would stay up until Candlemas. I've just, obviously I don't live in that house anymore, and the house I live in now isn't quite as big and isn't on the main road, whereas the previous house was on the main road, so it's very much witnessing to people. The light of Christ, passing from darkness into light. And as we're very much on the cusp of this new year, we hope that there's going to be a lot more light in this year. We've obviously been through a very dark, almost 2 years. It's a frightening thought that it's almost 2 years since this coronavirus pandemic broke out. And it's been a very dark time. We had the most amazing Christmas Day in Trevirbing Community Hall. We cooked 59 meals. About 25 of those were delivered out to people at home. But people came together to work, volunteer for other people, to eat together. And it was the most amazing occasion. I'm very grateful for all those people who helped and volunteered. Some people I'd never met before had turned up and mucked in. I had people who gave people lifts so they could get to the hall. It really, truly was this gospel of love being shared out. The gospel in action. And it was amazing. Some of those of us were doing, some of the people helping weren't Christians, some were. But what Christmas Day saw was just the most amazing climax of 4 months' work. When I started 4 months ago, I never know how it's going to be paid for. I never know how I'm going to, if I'm going to have enough help. Costs were covered. I ended up turning people down who wanted to help and volunteer because I just didn't have enough roles for them to fulfill. But what people saw there was the work of St. Joseph's Mission very much celebrating the birth of Jesus with people. And hopefully this year we'll be able to have a lot more community meals. I'm just beginning to start thinking about when we might hold those. Possibly six throughout the year, which will be an amazing achievement to bring people together. Living out the gospel. The gospel today tells us from his fullness we have all received grace upon grace, and we do need to look at what's good in our life. What is good in our lives comes from God. The good people around us. It's all very important that we remember as we go through the beginning of this year that there is light. There is hope. There is love, peace, and joy. Amen.
Let us declare our faith in God as we say together, we believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Lord God, as we begin this new year, we remember that your Son Jesus was born into our world and lived among us. As 2022 unfolds, we bring you our hopes and dreams, confident you will accompany us throughout the coming year. As 2022 begins, we pray for all religious leaders. May they inspire many people to work together to build a global community of justice, peace, and compassion. Lord, in your mercy. As 2022 begins, we pray for leaders in governments and communities across the world. May they cooperate in peace and an ever greater understanding of the real needs of the people they are called to serve. Lord, in your mercy. As 2022 begins, we pray for an end to the coronavirus pandemic. May God bless and reward all those who have generously given of themselves to support others in their time of need. Lord, in your mercy. As 2022 begins, we pray for the victims of oppression and injustice in their own countries. May migrants and refugees find a place of security and a future of hope. Lord, in your mercy. 2022 begins, we pray for people who face job insecurity in the current global economic upheaval. May they find work, fair wages and a hope-filled future. Lord, in your mercy. As 2022 begins, we pray for the sick, particularly for Margaret, for Isabel, for Anne, for Cheryl, for Pauline, for Phil, for Robert, for Bill, for Yvonne, for Baby Lee and Helena. May they find the healing of body, mind and spirit. Lord, in your mercy. As 2022 begins, we pray for the recently departed, particularly for Peter, for Fran, for Barry. May those who mourn find peace in their hearts. Lord, in your mercy. As 2022 begins, we pray for families. May their love for each other grow throughout the coming year, touching the hearts of everyone with whom they come into contact. Lord, in your mercy. Hear our prayers, Lord, which we trustfully bring before you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, lead us through the unfolding days of the new year. Amen. Glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to all in whom he delights. The peace of the Lord be always with you. And let us sing another carol.
Thank you.
be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. And now we give you thanks because in the incarnation of the Word, a new light has dawned upon the world. You have become one with us, and we might become one with you in your glorious kingdom. So with the angels and everyone in heaven, together we sing. Great and wonderful Father, we remember when Jesus had supper with his friends the night before he died. Jesus took bread and thanked you, broke it, gave it to his friends and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine. In thanking you, Jesus gave it to his friends and said, "All of you drink from this cup. Because this is my blood, the new promise of God's love. Do this every time you drink it to remember me." Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. So, loving Father, remembering how dearly Jesus loves us, we should love him too. Send your Holy Spirit, gentle as a dove, on us and on these gifts, so that everyone who eats and drinks this bread and wine, the body and blood of Jesus, we may be full of your life and goodness. Help us to walk hand in hand with Jesus and live our lives for him. All honour and glory belong to you, Father, through Jesus your Son, with the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen.
As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
We break the bread of life, and that life is the light of the world. God here among us, light in the midst of us, bring us to light and life. This is Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. So let us pray. All praise to you, Almighty God and Heavenly King, who sent your Son into the world to take our nature upon him, to be born of a pure virgin. Rather, as we are born again in him, he may continually dwell in us and reign on earth as he reigns in heaven, now and forever. Amen. And now we sing our final carol. It's been good to be with you again this Sunday, and I trust that going forward in this week that everything for you will be well. Can I take this opportunity again to wish you a Happy New Year, to wish you Happy Christmas as we continue through our Christmas season. It's been good to be with you, and I look forward to being with you next Sunday when we keep the Feast of the Epiphany. Christ, the Son of God, born of Mary, fill you with his grace to trust his promises and obey his will. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.